really love this lamp. Holy crap. So, a lot of stuff is going on in the house with the radiators. Got new curtains I'll show in a minute. How do you feel, Michael, about how the radiators came out?
I think the radiators came out pretty good. I'm just exhausted.
I know.
But they haven't even seen everything yet, because you've only showed them little snippets here and there.
We've got an update in the kitchen, and we will be sharing that with you really, really soon. It's being worked on as we speak.
2.0.
Yeah, kitchen makeover 2.0. And I'm really, really happy about it, because oh, I wanted it so bad.
It's going to be awesome.
Yeah, it's going to be great. So this is the at-home Karen. What do you call this? A Canadian tuxedo? Double denim? Let me just show you just a couple of new things that have come in. Nothing much, but just stuff for the house. Thought I'd update you. Hold on. So one thing I've been looking for is a rug for the studio. It's hardwood floors in here. They're beautiful, original wood floors, and they're stunning. But I just wanted something for my bare feet, especially during the winter time. So I'm gonna show you the rug that I got in. It's here, and it sits quite nicely, just centered beneath the sofa and the mirror right there. So it's quite nice. This is actually from Ruggable. This is not sponsored. Even though they gave me this, this is not. I just wanted to just show you how it looks. I wanted something that has like almost like boho meets vintage, if that makes sense. So that was kind of the thing I was going for. And I wanted something that was light colored as well, which is why I chose it. This little side table here in black, I love it. It actually was left from the tenant who used to rent this floor, because I'm on the second floor of the house. And as I've told you before, Michael and I were landlords, and we used to rent this floor that I'm talking to you in to tenants. And when they were leaving, you know, they mentioned about this, and I said I would love to have it. So this was left, so that's why. Also, it's from IKEA, because I checked it out, and it has the label underneath it, and it's from IKEA. And I did check, and I couldn't see it on IKEA's website, but if I do find it, I will definitely link it below. You guys already know about the pot here. This for my snakeskin? For my snake plant. Snakeskin, my God, I'm so obsessed with clothes and stuff. All right, so that's that, and also curtains. Got curtains for the place. There they are, flanking the French door. So nice. I was looking for something. I have not had anything here for almost a year. So, you know, at nighttime, I couldn't work up here. I would just go down to the living room, because at nighttime, you could just see straight in, at least through the French doors, because this looks out onto the street. Now I've finally got curtains, and they're fantastic. They are ultra long, which is what I wanted. They're from IKEA. The rod is from Amazon. It's a real kind of coppery brass color, and very simple. Kind of counterbalance to the rest of the studio, which has a lot of vintage touches. So I like the idea of having something that was quite contemporary and just very clean. I will link that for you. And like I said, the curtains are from IKEA, and I like, they're kind of like a linen-y texture. Let me see if you can see that. Yeah, you can a little bit. So there's that, and they're so lovely. There, I think, yeah, there you go. Right, really nice. So worth it, I think. I mean, a lot of you probably know that IKEA do some pretty good curtains. Inexpensive, but contemporary looking. So this definitely ticked off the box. It is ultra long, so it pulls on the floor on both sides. So I don't know, I might just have that hemmed. Although I kind of like the look of it, you know, just draping, but I know that's a nightmare, you know, to keep clean. But I do kind of like that look, because I know that is a vibe for some people, to just to leave it pulled, or if not, just, you know, obviously take it up so it's just skimming off the floor. So probably will end up doing that. Okay, so I know I'm on the floor, but I thought that was the best way for me to show you some new in little things that we've picked up. Oh God, this looks a bit dark, hold on. Okay, I don't know where to start. It's not a lot, but I feel like there's so much going on with the house, with just renovating. We're doing room by room, as you lot know. So, and it takes time, it really does. And it's a lot of trial and error. We don't have like a contractor. It's just Michael and I, and just picking out materials, design, you know, talking to the electrician, the plumber, the carpenter, the tiler. So that's how it's been going. But I'm going to show you, this is so random, but I want to show it to you. I did pick up this. Now I've had this, it's an old vintage, I don't think it's Moroccan, I think it's Turkish. I think it is, I got it from Etsy. Wood bowl, because as you know, we redid the kitchen and I wanted something, and it's very white and very bright overall. And the center island, which we've never had a center island before, but I feel like a little kid, it's granite top, white, like kind of marble effect. So I wanted some warmth with woods, but I didn't just want any old woods. I wanted just vintage or reclaimed woods, just old woods. I think to me, that's like, if you're gonna do it that way, for me at least. So I picked this up, which is huge. Look at this. This is so big. Here's my phone, iPhone 11. Oops, iPhone 11. So that gives you an idea of the size of this gigantic bowl, vessel thing. So it's a big piece. I've had this for about 6 weeks now. I got it from Etsy, like I said. I'll link the account of the Etsy seller that I picked this up from. He has some really great pieces and he has really good reviews. I wanted something that I could put anything in. At the moment, sitting downstairs with a white pumpkin in it with some fruit around it, but you could put anything in something like this. But it's just the warmth of it that I loved so much, the rusticness of it, just the fact that this looks like something that you definitely picked up from that kind of place. It doesn't look like something that you just walked into, like, I don't know, a shop and just picked this up, because it's just so oversized, it's so worn in, that, you know, this is something that you must have got special. And this sitting on top of the center island, oh god, it just looks so good. So yeah, I'm so pleased. I wanted something like this. I didn't want just like a normal wood bowl. I wanted something that was a bit more rustic. Sorry about that. For the small bathroom that we're still renovating, we are putting a counter. It's a small bathroom, so like I said, we never had a counter in that bathroom ever. So for the first time, we are gonna have one, and it's going to be in wood. And so we got this. This is just a sample. This is not it, because the actual piece of it, because we do have it, is so heavy. I'm not bringing it up to the studio, it's downstairs. But this is just a sample so you can see the type of texture of the wood piece that's going to be the bathroom counter. We got it from an amazing Brooklyn lumber place. Now they will cut any piece of lumber that they have for you to make, I don't know, if you want to make like open kitchen shelves, if you want to have like a bathroom countertop, which is what we're going to use this for, anything you want. They're so good. And the piece that we got for our bathroom cabinet, for our bathroom counter, it's on the side here, right on there, it looks like this, and on the top. It's so good, it's so nice. I can't wait. And we're gonna have a sink sit on top of it. So what we're gonna do is have a modern sink sitting on top of a reclaimed wood bathroom countertop, which will be this. And just contrast of something modern with something juxtaposed that is old timber is just, that's my jam. You know, they're like a genie. Like, you think of what you would like to have in the really like reclaimed wood rustic vibe, and they will make it for you. Just go down there, have a chat, and you can walk around, look at the wood, It's amazing. It's really, really good. I know a lot of restaurants and stuff, they said they have clients who, you know, they do like their restaurants, like furniture and tables, if they're looking for that kind of vibe, maybe bars that want that kind of cool bar tops, countertops. Anyway, they're incredible. So I'll, like I said, I'll leave their information below. If you do reach out to them, mention my name, Karen Britchick from YouTube, and I don't know if they'll give you a discount. They didn't say that. And they didn't give me anything for free, by the way. But, you know, I did say that I was going to mention them to you here. So definitely mention my name so they know, you know, that I sent you to them. But I think it's always important just to find all these nook and cranny gem places. Because I did show you them before in a video a couple of weeks ago, remember? And so that's the place. And a lot of you have asked me, you know, here or on Instagram especially, where is this place? Where is this amazing place? So that is them. I'm predicting that in two weeks, I should be hopefully putting up a update, something, some kind of reveal of some part of the place for you, whether it's the bathroom or the kitchen, because currently those are the two places that we are working on at the moment. I know you're thinking, why are you working on a kitchen? But it's just something that we're doing in there. Anyway, I'm gonna stop waffling. God, there's so much going on, it's not even funny. I have just been trying my best, not just throw anything into my mouth and just to be very careful, like with supplements and just try and, you know, just make sure I'm just taking care of myself. So I decided to try Care Of, which is a wellness brand. This is in partnership with them, by the way. I've actually run out of the supplements that I have, that I was taking. Honestly, this was a perfect opportunity for me to try something else. So Care Of is a wellness brand and it makes it really easy to take the right vitamins. Maybe you're looking for like healthier skin or energy, just supplements to help with like workout routines, or maybe there's a certain deficiency that you've got. So whatever your sort of health goals are, then you can try Care Of and they'll help you with that. So I wanted to try the brand out because all their products are clean. All right, so they're clean, they're good for you, which is one thing that I'm really trying to be very careful of and mindful of. I was looking for something that was going to help with fill any deficiencies that I was lacking, right? Because I know already of a couple that I automatically am, like iron, magnesium. I was also looking for anything could help me with stress, just to like, you know, just anything that helps with that. Natural, of course. So for me, after filling out the quiz, they knew that I needed magnesium, vitamin D, iron as well, fish oil. So I've got all of those things in here. And that's, like I said, that's a sachet that I take every single day. And I also got these, they're called chill sticks. And these are for stress, but these is powder form and it's natural based. So it's not like, you know, when you think of like something to just de-stress you, this is all natural. For me, I know that I need to just fill in the holes that my diet isn't giving me. And especially like with working out as well, I'm not doing it as much as I should be. I know I need to get on that. You know, it can get a bit daunting because you just walk into a shop and you just see like tons of them out there. So with Care Of, it cuts through all of that because you take a quiz and it's a holistic quiz that helps sort out what are your health goals, what your lifestyle is, also your diet, how is it, like rating it, how is your diet at the moment. And the recommendations that they give to you are all from health and wellness experts, which is fantastic. Care Of shows you all the studies and all the research behind their products. So it's peace of mind and you feel like you know where everything is coming from. And so once you've done the quiz, you're able to figure out what exactly your health needs are, what it is that you're looking to achieve, what is it you need, what is it you're missing. It's not like I've got like 5 or 6 bottles all there with, and I've got to take one of each thing, or I've got to take one supplement that's supposed to do it all, because I don't think that's true. I think everyone is different in terms of what they need. Oh, and if you do give it a try, you're going to get 50% off your first order. So half price right off the bat. I'll leave obviously my promo code for that on the screen here and I'll link it for you below. You are very welcome. All right, so let's get the rest of this day going. So I'm outside and I'm going to show you the radiators that Michael has been renovating. We managed to pick up 3. 2 are large, 1 is smaller. I've been talking to you guys on Instagram about this, but I'm going to share them with you so you can see how they look, because we love old radiators. And these came out so nice because they were like all kind of rusted before. I'm going to insert some pictures so you can see the before of what they look like and you can see how they look now. This is the after. This is how they look. They look absolutely stunning. They look like a gajillion dollars. They are so nice. I'm so happy with how they've come out. Look at that. So good. Oh, it says American radiator, I think there. Look at that. So nice. Michael got special spray for them. It's called engine spray, high temperature, heat resistant spray. I think that's it. So this is one of the radiators, one of the taller ones. Excuse the mess back here. This is obviously the little one, the smaller one, and another taller one right here. I just wanted to show you how nice these came out. So good. So what Michael did is, and I'll show you, first he took the rust off because they were all rusted, all three. Took that off. Once that was off, and you dust that off, he sprayed them in black and then covered the black with gold. It was my suggestion to do the black first. He originally just painted it gold, but I thought it looked a bit flat. So I suggested that he paint black under, which he did, and then put the gold on top, and that helps to just create some depth to the lighter gold. On Instagram, you've already seen this, how Michael did it, just spraying it. But for YouTube, I just obviously want to show you here so you can see, you know, what we've been up to, which is just DIYing some stuff. And this is obviously going to go inside. This one is probably going to go in the living room. The other big one is going to go in the dining area. And this one, I couldn't decide if this should go in my studio or not. Actually, I asked on Instagram, so I'm going to ask you lot now what you think. Okay, so remember seeing this one, okay? Just remember this, because I'm going to go back upstairs. I'm thinking about swapping out one of them, the smaller one upstairs, with this one instead. So let me know if you think I should. Hold on. Okay, so these are the two radiators existing, you know, in the studio space. This is a smaller one, and this is where I'd put that old gold one, you know, that we sprayed. Right here. The plan was to put it here, but it's two different types of gold. But does that matter? Because the one that we sprayed is a little bit of a brighter, vibrant gold compared to, say, my standing mirror, which is this kind of like a bronzy, darker gold, and also the back wall as well. You know, this mirror back here, same thing. See that kind of gold? I mean, it's stunning, right? But it's different, right? To what the radiator is. And also, so do I bother putting it in? And then another thing is, here is silver. So we'd have one old gold one, right, old gold mirror, and then one that's silver here. So I don't know. I know an option is to spray this gold, but I'm just wondering if it's going to be too much gold in the whole room. You know what I mean? Like two gold radiators, and then you've got this mirror, and then behind me, you know, the sofa and the mirror. I don't know. Is that too much gold in the space? I'm just not sure if that's too much or not. I don't know. I don't want to paint them any other color. Like, I don't want to paint the small radiator, the, you know, the gorgeous old one. I don't want to paint that like silver to match the, you know, the larger silver one. I like it in the gold. I think it's gorgeous. So I want to keep it that way. So what do I do? Leave me a comment below. Tell me what you think. Or maybe I just don't even put it in this room because I'm worried it's going to clash, you know, sitting next to the standing mirror. Do I just don't put it in here at all and just put it in Michael's office? I don't know. And, you know, just in another room, so I can't decide.
I say find another radiator that's old and vintage and stick it right there.
That's a good idea! Are you serious?
Why? That's all. It has more sections, because the one you have has only a few sections, like right. Maybe five. Find one that has like maybe eight sections.
Okay, and just...
But same height.
Yeah.
If you're going to have two of them in here.
Just put silver instead, just so,
because
it'd be too much.
You don't want to be like,
I'm taking that out of this video. That's not going to be in there. We don't want it to be like Versace Vegas. I'd rather have accents of gold rather than just walk in here and it's just like you need sunglasses because there's so much gold everywhere. Yeah. Let me know what you think. Okay, so yeah, thank you. Where is it again? Well, hi, sorry. We are in New Jersey.
Paramus,
New Jersey. We're going to check out a tile outlet place for our bathroom, the guest bathroom that we are renovating, basically. But while we're out here, there are so many, there's so many outlets here. It's not even funny. There is Home Sense is here, Home Goods is here, West Elm is here. Just all the shops are here, and plus there are outlets as well. So on the way back, I'm gonna obviously vlog it for you and take you guys
turn right
with us after we turn right. Okay, so we just arrived. What am I in? Frankie B dress, worn as a top. I don't know. Oh, Farm Rio is the skirt. And carrying the Chanel Trendy. What else? In the Crazy Crib. Who sings that? I think it's Prince. Oh God, sorry Prince. Okay, so we're inside and they've got like all these displays already set up for you. I'm not really liking these, but I mean, it's just the fact that they do that, which I think is really cool. Well, it's not bad, it's quite cute. So we've just seen this tile and we really, really like it. Possibly for the bathroom floor.
Like right now, they're not even over here.
Just looks like stone. So nice. Okay, so we just saw this tile and we like it too. Oh, I don't know. What do you guys think? I love herringbone. Wow, so much tile everywhere. Look at all of this. So we left with this piece. It's a sample. It's actually missing tiles, they give it to us for half price. But we're gonna place this on the floor and see what we think. But I really like this for the bathroom, this herringbone style. It's so pretty. Look how nice the trees are around here. Oh, oh, that's so pretty. Okay, so Michael is just parking and there is a Home Sense here in the area. So of course I'm going. Like I told you I would. God, sorry the light is like this. I've actually been into this one. I've just realized that we've been here in this area before, we just didn't realize it. So I'm going to hop in now and we'll see what it's like today. This is quite pretty. Wow, this is for someone who really has like a boudoir. This feathered light. Okay, now we're at West Elm. I already want this plant. All right, so we're in Crate and Barrel. Just letting you see what it looks like in here. It's huge.
I don't think they're selling their real plants.
No, I think there's a... Are these...
That's real.
That's real. I did like these dining chairs though. Thought those were really, really cool. Like how modern it is. And you know that we're looking for something for the farmhouse table. We need a pair of dining chairs to go on the opposite side. Because on the other side is a bench. What do you think? I love this mirror. This is gorgeous. I love it. We're thinking just to put it in the bathroom. Above the sink. I thought this West Elm accent chair was pretty nice. I like the finish on it, this. That's what I like, stuff like that. Mid-century, nice low profile. Really nice. I know, right? So now we're at Crate and Barrel. We're gonna see what it's like. Thank you. I always like the idea of like a really dramatic light fixture over a table, which is why we have like a chandelier over ours, our dining table. And this, I thought this was interesting. Again, I'm looking for a pair of dining chairs. Okay, so I'm always looking to see what I think would work. And I want something that looks a bit contemporary. These aren't too bad. How much are these, by the way? This is $4.99. Yeah. Okay, so we're thinking about this. For our bar stool. I just like how simple it is. Simple black with the silhouette of it. And don't forget our center island, that part is white gray marble. It's like this. But under here.
So these would be contrasting against that white marble. So I was looking at this pastry slab. Yeah, French kitchen marble pastry slab. It is so big, but I really like it. I can imagine it being used maybe for something else. I'm not sure what, but because it's such a nice large piece, I feel like you could use it for something else.
And the theme of this area is curves. But upstairs in this area is massive. Oh, this is not bad. I actually like this.
Love a good round mirror. Hello. Not bad. Not bad for a media console.
I always love these kind of chairs. Any kind of lattice leather chair is something I'm always, always drawn to when it's combined with a beautiful finished wood. Oh my gosh, I'm not sure where I'd put it, but I love this light. I love this light. I really, really, really love this lamp. Holy crap, it's $2.29. Oh gosh, it's gorgeous. All right, one of those moments where you have to think, where would I put it because I love it so much. I'm looking for a round mirror, large, oversized, to sit at the head of the dining table. And we saw this and it's trimmed in black. The wall is white. So yeah, I don't know, quite like this. This is great. Okay, oh God, the light is so bright. So just left and liked a lot of the things there, especially love that round mirror, really nice. It's just what we're actually thinking about for above the dining room table. So it was $4.99 for a Crate and Barrel, loved it. Did not take it because I know places like Home Goods and stuff, they find, I usually see round mirrors. It's just the dimension. It needs to be a good 48 inches dimension, which is pretty large, but that's what I want. I want a nice large round mirror. So we'll see what we get. Last stop before we go home, the outlet. Just checking out the mirrors that they've got. Hello. All right, so the house reno continues. What am I wearing? I've got on the jumpsuit, it's a two-piece tie-dye from Etsy. I'll link this below. I love this thing. You followers mentioned it on Instagram and it's true. It looks like, you know, the ocean, like the bottom of the ocean. It has that kind of vibe to it. I thought I'd wear it with my Doc Martens. I've really just been into tie-dye. I'm just like completely, I've just given in to loving it. But the Loewe puzzle, with the Kate strap, which I've recommended to you guys before. We're gonna pick up the wood for the bathroom, the small bathroom. There'll be a full bathroom vlog renovation before and after, just like I did with the kitchen. We'll do it with that. So but I'm including you in the process of like what's going on. So yeah, so we're gonna pick up the wood counter. Anyway, I'm off. I'll take you with me, obviously. We're back. Remember this place the other day? The lumber place in Brooklyn. We're back to pick up our piece. They've finished it.
We're here.
Back again. Oh, there it is.
Where? I don't see it.
I'm not sure what you're at.
This is it. It's what we're using for the bathroom.
These are the extra pieces.
Reclaimed wood.
Okay, two more. Yep. And then these are the shorter ones, and these are the two longer ones.
Cool. Hey.
Try and keep the cloverwood, the
cover. We're trying to go home with the pieces of wood